In chapter 4, we are looking at basic shapes in technology and design. And here, in our activity 4, we are looking at practice in the application. The application
of basic shapes.
The application of basic shapes. Practice in the application of basic shapes. And in activity 4.1, we are looking at triangles. So basically, we begin by defining what a triangle is. A triangle is a plane figure whose sides are straight and they are three in number, enclosed by three straight sides. A plane figure enclosed by three straight sides. There are various types of triangles. These include the equilateral triangles. We have the right angle triangles. We have the isosceles triangles and the scaling triangles. Now, these triangles have features or properties. The properties of triangles include: 1, the sum of the interior angles of a triangle add up to 180 degrees. 2, the sum of the lengths of the three sides of the triangle are referred to as the perimeter. 3, the perpendicular height drawn from the base of a triangle to its highest vertex is known as the altitude or vertical height. 4, the angles formed at the ends of the base of a given triangle are called base angles. 5, the angle formed at the highest vertex of the triangle is referred to as the vertical angle. Now, after looking at these properties and taking note of them, we are going to go ahead and go into the actual practicing of the application of the basic what? Shapes. In this case, we are strictly referring to the construction of triangles. Which triangles we have mentioned, we have defined what a triangle is, the different types of triangles, and the features or properties of any triangle. Here we are going to begin by looking at 1, an equilateral triangle. An equilateral triangle. An equilateral triangle has all its sides equal or similar in length, and all angles of an equilateral triangle are also equal. This can be arrived at by getting the angle sum of the triangle, which we have already reflected upon in the features of a triangle. And of course the angle sum we say is equivalent to 180 degrees. So when you divide by the three sides, you realize that each of the angles of an equilateral triangle are 60 degrees. And of course, if you multiply the 60 by 3, you get the angle sum. Let's look at its construction. Now, what I may call the procedure or the steps to follow when you are constructing an equilateral triangle. In this case, we shall take an example of constructing an equilateral triangle given the length of side. And of course, bearing in mind that all the sides of a triangle are equal, whereby you are given one side, it means all the other three sides are equivalent to that one side, which means all the sides are 60 millimeters long. Now, step one, you begin by setting up a baseline, a construction baseline, which is a faint construction line, after which, with your pair of compass, you take the reading given, which is 60 millimeters, from the ruler. You read off 60 from the ruler and mark it off along the baseline. Let those arcs be labeled A and the other one B. Having that done that without adjusting the radius of your compass, use point A as your center and strike an arc above the baseline. Change over with the same radius to center B and repeat the same. Strike an arc to intercept or to meet the first one, struck from point A. Where those two arcs meet will generate vertex C of the required triangle. Now, finally, you join those points, join C to A, and C to B. Then you outline between A and B. The outcome is your required equilateral triangle A, B, C. When you are through with that, we shall look at the second type of triangle, which is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle has the following characteristics or properties. An isosceles triangle has two base angles which must be equal. Then the base, the sides, the upper sides of the isosceles triangle are also equal in size, in length. Now we shall take an example of constructing an isosceles triangle. Given its base, isosceles triangle, given its base, has 73 millimeters, and altitude has 45 millimeters. Base is 73 millimeters and altitude is 45, whereby the altitude is similar to the vertical height of the triangle. That is the perpendicular distance from the baseline, from the base of the triangle to the highest vertex of the triangle. So we shall also begin by drawing a baseline, the construction baseline, because we are not certain of its dimensions. Then, with your pair of compass, you take off the base, in this case, which is 73 millimeters, from your ruler, take 73 millimeters. Come on the baseline, step off that dimension by striking the axis on the baseline. Let's call that X and this one Y. Now, the altitude, which is the vertical height, is 45 millimeters. And how do you get the vertical height of an isosceles triangle? You bisect between X and Y. Strike axis up and down, or above and below the baseline. And then you draw your bisector at the points of intersection. You draw the bisector faintly. It's a construction line, it should not be an outline. Thereafter, you input, you take the distance of 45 on your compass and bring it at the baseline, and you strike off an arc along the bisector. So that height is 45 millimeters and is an equivalent to our altitude of the given of that particular triangle. So when you mark off, that gives you vertex. That's why this becomes your vertex Z. Now, to close your figure, you join Z to X and Z to Y. Then you outline between X and Y. Figure XYZ gives you the required triangle, which is an isosceles triangle. And the base angles X and Z XY, this one, and x, y, z, this one, are equal. And if you wanted to prove it, you can take even the measurements. You realize that x, x, z is equal to y, z. And to be fulfilling the properties or the features that we have discussed about the properties of an isosceles triangle. We go to another triangle. Scalene triangle is a triangle whose sides are not equal at all. Each side is of a different dimension, and the angles are also not equal. They differ. Now, we shall look at an example of constructing a scalene triangle given sides as (45 millimeters), 57 millimeters, and 65 millimeters. Still, like the other triangles we have handled above, we begin by drawing a construction baseline. You choose any of the dimensions given to be your base. In this case, I'm taking 57 as my base. To read off 57 from the ruler, and you mark it off along the baseline. Call this P and call the other Q. Now, to get the third vertex, PQ become your vertices, the base vertices of the required triangle. So, to get the third vertex, you read off 45 from the ruler with your pair of compass, center P, and you strike an arc. And the last side is 65 millimeters. You read off 65 from your ruler with your pair of compass. Then using center P, center Q as your center, you intercept or you strike another arc to meet the first arc drawn from center P. That one, that point of intersection will give you points, will generate point PQR. And finally, to bring out your required triangle, you outline by joining those points R to Q. Then R to P, and then we outline between P and Q, and you come up with your required triangle P Q R. Remember that all sides of this triangle are not equal, neither the angles. Each angle is different from the other. We proceed and look at a right angled triangle. A right-angled triangle is one which has one of its angles forming 90 degrees. For example, if you looked at this set square, this angle here, assuming this is my base, this angle here and that side, the angle formed between the base and the side is 90 degrees. So similarly, the right-angled triangle has one of its angles formed as those on this set square. Now, when you look at its construction, we are going to construct a right-angled triangle given its base (40 millimeters) and altitude or vertical height 55 millimeters. We are given those two. We have the base 40 and the vertical height or altitude as 55 millimeters. We begin still by constructing the baseline. Onto which we read off and mark the given base, which is 40 millimeters. That is 40, and I may call it ST. Those are the base vertices of the required triangle. So, at any of the points, either S or T, you set up a perpendicular In here, you adjust the compass to a radius of your choice and strike, and you draw a semi circle. Now, use the points where the semicircle touches the baseline as your centers to a radius of your choice still, strike and up above the baseline. Change over to the other point of the semicircle and do the same. Now, where those two arcs meet generates point U, vertex U of the right angle triangle. To complete the drawing, you join U to S. And U to T. Then you join between S and T, the outline. The outcome STU is your required right angle triangle. Read and mark off the exact base, in this case 40 millimeters. This gives you vertex S and T. At either S or T, whichever side you choose, you set up a semicircle whose radius is up to your choice. Now, using the points at which that semicircle circumference touches the base line, you readjust your compass to a fair radius and strike an arc up. Change over without changing the radius. Change over the centers to the other end of the semicircle, and you strike another arc. Having finished that, join S through the intersection of the arcs. That will give you the perpendicular, which is in this case 90 degrees. And of course, since the triangle is right angle, then that is the angle that qualifies it for that nail. Now, you go ahead and input the vertical height of the altitude, which is in this case 55 millimeters. Come center S and strike off the vertical height 55 millimeters. That point becomes your point U. Now join U to T. and outline the remaining two sides. US and ST. There you will have come up with your required right angle triangle STU. Any triangle inscribed in a semicircle whose hypotenuse is equal to the diameter of the semicircle is a right angled triangle. Any triangle inscribed in a semicircle whose hypotenuse is equal to the diameter of the semicircle is a right angled triangle. And the right angled triangle is also used as a basis of the Pythagoras theorem, whereby the hypotenuse TU squared is equal to ST squared plus SU. Now, looking at the first explanation of a circle subtended in a semi, of a triangle being subtended in a semicircle forming a right angle. In this case, we are going to look at constructing a right angled triangle. Given its hypotenuse, given its hypotenuse as mm. And one other side mm. What do we do? Remember that the hypotenuse should be equivalent to the diameter of the semicircle. So we begin by drawing a construction line. On it, mark off the given hypotenuse, which is 65 millimeters. Let this be my A and this B. Equivalent 65 millimeters. Now, since AB, which is the hypotenuse, is equal to the diameter of the semicircle, then to get the semicircle drawn, we should first determine its radius. That calls for getting the midpoint of A and midpoint between A and B. And how do we achieve that? We have to bisect between A and B. Bisect between A and B. And after the bisection, you draw the bisector. Purpose of that bisector is to be able to determine the radius of the required semicircle in which the triangle is to be constructed. So, with that midpoint, radius A or B, you draw a semicircle. After drawing the semicircle, you input the side given as 38 millimeters. How? You read off 38 from your ruler. 38. With either center A or B, you strike an arc. Either with the center A or B, you strike an arc to intersect the circumference of the semicircle. Intercept the circumference of the semicircle. And that generates point vertex C of the required triangle. Then you join C to A and C to B. Then you outline between A and that gives you the required right angle triangle, and the right angle is at that point. If you want to prove, you can either use your set square to check if it is perpendicular, or you may use your protractor to prove that. Now we are going to look at more other triangles. Having finished to look at the types we had mentioned earlier on, now we are going to draw triangles falling within that category but given different features of the triangle properties. For example, in this case, we are going to construct a triangle given the perimeter, its perimeter, and the ratio of sides. Given perimeter and ratio of sides. Perimeter P. Let perimeter B, P be 110 millimeters, and the ratio be 1:2:3:4 in that order. You are given the perimeter and ratio of the sides. Perimeter is 110 millimeters and ratio of sides as 2 to 3 to 4. As usual, start on by drawing a baseline. Find construction line. We read off the given perimeter, 110, and step it off along that line. Now, when you are dealing with the ratio, you sum up the ratio. You say 2 plus 3 plus 4, which equals to 11. Which is the total of this is 9. So you drop, you will memory call that when you are dividing a line into a number of equal parts, you drop a line at an angle of your choice from any end of the line given. And then, with your pair of compass, you are going to step off 9 equal arcs along the dividing line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Where 9 is the sum of the given what? The total of the given ratio. Now, you join 9 to the end of the baseline. Then you adopt that line . So here we have, first of all, the first ratio is 2. Let's highlight that. Then the next ratio is 3. So 2 plus 3 comes to 5. Then 5 plus 4, giving you 9. Now, you adopt that line you have joined from 9 to the end of the end of the given perimeter. You adopt that line with your ruler and set square. Place your ruler, your set square, on the line like that. Then sit your ruler or straight edge under the set square. Keep the ruler fixed and only slide the set square to the highlighted positions, which is 0.5, there, continue slide up to 0.2. So those three lines are parallel to each other. This one is parallel to that and that. To get the polygon, I mean to get the triangle in the question, you use always the middle ratio, which is 3. 1, 2, 3. This middle ratio here acts as the base of your required triangle. So you use position 2 to 0 and you strike, adjust your compass that radius and strike and up. Similarly, go to the ratio 4 at the far end of the base, center end of the base, radius 9. Strike another arc backwards to intercept the first arc. After which, you join the intersection of the arc to parallel to and parallel 5. And then you outline the middle ratio of the baseline. The figure outlined is the required triangle. So, first add up the given ratio, get the total. The total there gives you the steps you are to make on the aiding line here, which assists you to divide the perimeter into the given ratio. Take a radius of your choice and step off 9 steps along that line. Join the last point 9 to the end of the 110. Adopt that line you have joined between those 2 points with your set square and ruler and slide to position 5. Draw that parallel and continue to position 2. Draw that parallel. After which, those 2 points, 2 and 3, give you the base of the required triangle. So use center 2, radius 0, and strike that arc. Center 5, radius 9, strike another arc. Where they meet gives you the upper vertex of the required triangle. Let's look at given the perimeter base and base angle. Constructing a triangle given verse 37 millimeters. Base angle degrees and perimeter. And perimeter of two sides. Perimeter of two sides, say 105 millimeters. Take the normal trend, begin by setting up a baseline. On that baseline, mark off the base. Mark off the base. In this case, 37 millimeters.
perimeter. And two base angles. Say degrees and 90 degrees. Here, as usual, begin by setting up the baseline. On it, mark off the given perimeter. Given perimeter 118. Input the given angles. How? Construct 60 at one end of the perimeter. And 90 at the other end. Is 90 degrees. Those are the angles at the ends of the triangle. Now we bisect those angles with our compass. We bisect those two angles using this point. Strike an arc, change over down. Strike another up, and you draw the bisector. Repeat that for the other end of the perimeter. Use that point, strike and up, change over to there, and also strike and up. Then, still draw the bisector of that angle. Now, where these two bisectors meet gives you the upper vertex of the required triangle. The upper vertex of the required triangle. Now, to draw the triangle with your ruler and set square, adopt the first angles given. You adopt the 60 here. The 60 degrees
with a set square and place the ruler under the set square. Keep it fixed and you slide your set square to that point where the bisectors intersect. You draw a parallel. This is parallel to that. Similarly, you adopt the perpendicular here. And slide it along the straight edge to that vertex and you draw a parallel to it. The triangle formed in between there. The triangle formed in between there is your required triangle. That there is your required triangle. Bear in mind that this side of the triangle is adopted from that, or is parallel to this 60 angle line. And this side of the triangle is adopted from the perpendicular there. This is parallel to that, and this is parallel to this. Then the base comes automatically along the initial baseline, but between those two parallels, you get this base. And with that, you wind up the application of triangles. Now, we shall take a brief look at construction of quadrilaterals. Is a shape with four, is a plane figure or a shape with four straight sides. Types of quadrilaterals include squares, rectangles, kites, parallelograms, rhombus, and a trapezium. Of which these shapes may be used in a combination or in isolation. For example, if you combine squares alone, you'd end up with a tube. And if you combine a square with a rectangle, you'll end up with a cuboid. If you combine a rectangle and a circle, you end up with a cylinder. If you combine a triangle and a square, you end up with a pyramid, and so on.
So, here we have looked at triangles already. Now let's take a look at the squares, I mean the quadrilaterals. Now, here we shall construct some of the quadrilaterals. These include squares, rectangle, square, a rectangle, a rhombus, trapezium. We shall begin by looking at square construction. One given length of side. By construction line, with your compass, grid off the length of side given. Say 55 millimeters. Adjust your compass to 55 millimeters, step off that on the baseline. 55. At one end, set up the perpendicular radius of your choice. So you can arc without adjusting the radius, intercept. Come to that point, intercept, and draw an arc backwards. Change over to that position, intercept there. Now, what you draw here is the perpendicular. It's at 90 to the baseline. Unlike triangles, for that was have an angle sum of 360 degrees. The interior angles of any quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. In this case, we are looking at a square A square has all sides equal, all its sides are equal in length. Two, the diagonals of a square are also equal and bisect each other at right angles. Now, given that all the sides of the triangle are equal, it means that if my side given is 55 there, which I used on the base, I'll just strike an arc along the perpendicular without changing that radius. Come to that point, position, strike another arc, shift to the other end of the base with the same radius, and also strike an arc. Then, when you join through, you'll have the four vertices P, Q, R, S. Gives you the required square when given its side. Two, let's look at given its diagonals. As 85 millimeters. The diagonals of a square are equal. And so, if you are given one of its diagonals as that, it means the other also is 85 millimeters. Now, in this case, since the diagonals bisect the sides of the square at 45 degrees, it is good practice for you to have a baseline and at any point of your choice along the baseline, you set up a diagonal which is at 45 degrees, using a 45 degree set square. To set up a diagonal, this is a 45 degree set square. So you set up a diagonal at an angle for 45 degrees. That with your compass, you read off the length of the diagonal, which is 85 millimeters. Come there, strike of 85. The distance from that point to there is equivalent to the length of the given diagonal, 85. Now, you bisect this diagonal. Strike up and down, change over. Do the same. The bisector gives you the second diagonal. The bisector gives you the second diagonal. And when you get the second diagonal, back the first diagonal, get that dimension 85, bring it here, step of 85. So thereafter you join through those points. You join this and that, and then close. And you end up with your required square, whose diagonals are 85 millimeters long. Alternatively, you may use an alternative method. Construct that baseline, read my diagonal 85, bring it here, bisect that 85. Draw the bisector. With that center generated from the bisector, radius end of the first 85, you draw a circle. After drawing the circle, the points at which the diagonal and the bisector, its bisector, intercept the circumference of the circle will give you the side of the required square. That is an alternative method, the first one. That is a square done. Now next, we are looking at construction of a rectangle. even
its sides. As 70 and 40 millimeters. Start by drawing the baseline faintly. Read off and mark one of the sides, which is 70 millimeters. And mark of 70 millimeters there. The rectangle properties are almost similar to those of a square. It has equal diagonals in length, but it only differs from a square in that it has two opposite sides equal and parallel to each other. So the sides meet at 90 degrees. So I set up 90 degrees. That is 90. After which I'll step off my 40 millimeters. This is my 40 along the perpendicular. So when I strike off that 40, I also bring it to this end of the 70 line and strike an arc. Then adopt the 70 and bring it up here. Then intercept the first arc. And then it joins through in so doing, you will have generated your required rectangle whose sides are 70 by 40, 70 lengths and 40 widths. You realize that the opposite sides are parallel to each other and equal in length. And then they meet all the corners. Form right angles, 90 degrees at each corner. Next, we look at the rhombus. The rhombus, like a square, has all its sides equal. It has an angle sum of all the interior angles add up to 360 degrees. And these diagonals are not equal. One is longer than the other. But bisect each other at 90 degrees. Diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles at 90 degrees. And all sides of a rhombus are equal. Opposite angles are people. Now, Rhombus going to look at construction of a rhombus given side 50 millimeters and diagonal. You have the side and the diagonal given. So, you draw a diagonal at any angle.
and an angle. Parallelogram has opposite sides parallel to each other and equal. Opposite sides are equal. Diagonals are not equal in lengths, and they do not bisect each other at 90 degrees. They are not equal and they don't bisect each other at 90 degrees. But they bisect each other into two equal parts. Now, when you are given the side and an angle, you could be given the shorter side or the longer side. So you begin by setting up a baseline. Along that baseline, take a point of your choice and set up the angle 75. Set up 75. I'm beginning by setting up 90 degrees. Which is there. Then, since I want 75, with this same radius here, used to construct the semicircle. With this radius used to construct the semicircle, I strike off there, and in so doing, I have set up 60 degrees from 90, remaining with 30. This space here from here to there is 30 degrees, whereas from here to there is 60. And the total from here to there is 90. And yet, 75 is half of 30. So, I bisect my 30 degrees here. Bisect my 30 between here and there. Then I get my my 75. This here is 75 degrees. Now, along that 75 is where I would wish to place my side 35 millimeters. So, I'll read off my 35 here, bring it there, step off 35. After doing that, I missed up something. This was saying, length of given sides were supposed to be 2. This or something is an omission here. Yeah. So I said this is 65 meters. So I'll bring here my 65. Shift to that point, step of 65 millimeters. Then go back to this side and take off the 35. Bring it at this end of 65 and strike and up to intercept the first one. Then the required parallelogram is there. That is my required parallelogram, whose sides are 35 wide and 65 long, and forming an angle of 75 degrees. So draw the baseline, mark off 65 lengths. At one end, construct the given angle, which is 75 in this case. By construction, begin by constructing 90, remove 60, basing here and there. So the balance here is 30, bisect that 30, and generate the 75. Now, along the 75, mark off the width of the parallelogram, which is 35 millimeters. Then use it at the other end of the length to strike an arc, basing here with the length there, you base there and intercept the first arc. Then you join through. And you get your required parallelogram. Given. Given parallel sides. Parallel sides. Perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance. Other side of perpendicular distance between the sides. Between the sides. And one angle. A trapezium is a quadrato, is a plane figure which has only two of its sides that are parallel. The other two are not parallel to each other. And the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides is also referred to as the altitude. Now, we shall begin by setting up one of its sides along the base as our baseline. Parallel sides. Sides. Say 80 and 50. Perpendicular distance, altitude. Let's say 60 degrees. Now, after setting up this, I'll input the altitude, which is 35. So you read off 35 from your ruler, 35 millimeters. Concept of drawing parallel lines using the compass. Strike that and strike that at any point along the baseline. Then over the axis, you draw a tangential line which qualifies to be parallel to the baseline at the perpendicular distance of 35. One of the sides is 80. So, with my compass, go to the ruler, read off 80. Come to the baseline, mark off 80 millimeters. After marking off 80, at one end of the 80, I'm going to set up 60. Degrees, the given angle, 60. So, the angle here is 60 degrees. Then the other side is 50. I'll take this mark of 50 on the upper parallel line. Then I close my figure. Close my figure. And I get my required parallelogram. This side is parallel to that one. That is our trapezium required. workshops you were doing. A polygon is a plane figure bounded by more than four straight lines.